Hey there, everybody. It's Linnea for ThermoWeb, and today I'm going to be bringing you a holiday card featuring Gina K Designs. So I will be using the Baby It's Cold Outside stamp and foil system, as well as some Glitz Glitter Gels. I'm going to start, though, with the Rena K Designs Sending Sunshine stencil. I'm just using the stencil. I wanted to have some snow in the background, and I thought these little bubbles would really look like some cute little clusters or flurries of snow. So I sprayed the back of that stencil with some pixie spray. Just a light application of the pixie spray is all you really need. And I set that down on my work surface to dry, and I'm just kind of holding it over my paper, deciding where I want it to go. I thought about having both sides kind of hanging off the edge, going horizontally, going more vertical, and I ended up on a diagonal. I'm now going to take some purple tape. I'm using the 1.5 inch size here, and I'm just going to mask off the sides of the stencil as well as the edges of my cardstock. When I'm using Glitz Glitter Gel, I kind of stencil and spread my glitz all over the place, so I want to make sure I have my cardstock taped off so I don't get any glitz where I don't want it to be. Now I'm taking two colors of Gina K Designs Glitz Glitter Gel, Grass Green and Red Velvet, and I'm actually going to mix these two colors together. So normally when you would mix green and red together, you're going to get brown because these two colors don't mix. But because these colors aren't actually going to blend together, I hope that makes sense, there is green glitter versus red glitter. And though the glitters will kind of mix together, they're not actually going to blend together. So I'm not going to get brown. I'm going to have areas of green glitter and areas of red glitter. And I will try to definitely capture that in the photos because it's a really pretty background in real life, but it's hard to capture in the video. It kind of just turns up green. So you can mix these two together however you want, and I do want to mention that I used quite a bit of Glitz Glitter Gel here. You don't want to use this much if you're only stenciling the one background. Now this is only going to take up like maybe half a size of a stencil, but I was able to stencil four backgrounds from this, and so I just set all of those aside, and I'll use them in future projects. I'm going to use my Stencil Pal to spread that Glitz Glitter Gel all over the top, and I'm going to scrape off as much as I can because I can't put this back into the jar since it's mixed, so I might as well scrape off as much as I can and use them, like I said, on other backgrounds. So here you go. I hope you can kind of see that it is definitely red and green glitter mixed together, but they're not meshing together. They're not blending together. They're just kind of together. I set that panel aside to dry, and now I'm going to work with the Gina K Designs Baby It's Cold Outside stamp and foil system. I took out one of the papers from the foil sheets. These are like the foil add-on sheets, and the back of the packaging tells you exactly how to work with these foil mates. It tells you to preheat your laminator at the 5 mil setting, and it tells you to line up the stamps from the Baby It's Cold Outside stamp set with the foil mates and stamp the coordinating layering snowflake and then die cut and then add foil. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do here. I'm going to be stamping in red and green ink. Four snowflakes in each color. I kind of wanted to keep the color pattern of the background with the Glitz Glitter Gel going through the snowflakes too. So I lined up the snowflakes that I wanted to add on top, and now I'm just going to stamp them with red ink. And then I'll clean these stamps and line them up again with the ones on the top and stamp in green. So I'll have four snowflakes in red and four snowflakes in green. Now, I didn't get my first snowflake lined up very well. That's okay. I'm still going to cut it out. I just don't end up foiling it. So once my snowflakes are stamped, and I do want to say that there's a lot of stamps in that Baby It's Cold Outside stamp set. And some of the outline images I thought could work with multiple snowflakes. So that's why I had kind of a hard time deciding which snowflake design I liked the best. I'm going to take the coordinating dies, and I'm just using some purple tape, this time the 1/2 inch wide version, to tape the dies in place over my images. Now remember that this purple tape is pressure activated, so you want to just give that a little press before running it through your die cutting machine. Now I have the Gina K Designs Glimmering Gold Fancy Foil Sheets. You could use the Gina K Designs or the Deco Foil Transfer Sheets. Both will work beautifully. You want to put your foiled design so that the black markings on the snowflake, they want to touch the back side of the foil, so the silver side. I'm just going to line up as many of these snowflakes as I can on this. It's actually a scrap sheet of the foil, but it worked out perfectly. I didn't end up foiling that one snowflake, but that's because I stamped it so poorly that it looked wonky when I die cut it. I'm going to just line them up on the foil. Remember, you want the toner to touch the back side of the foil. And I am going to run this through my laminator. I'm running it through twice just for good measure, but you probably don't have to. It's just something that I do. And when I'm done, I'm going to peel these off the backer sheet. I kind of peel slowly just to help them release and make sure that I'm not going to damage the foil, although I've never had any trouble damaging that. And look at this. I hope you can see the shine of the foil. It really is pretty in real life. It has just a little bit of that accent foil up against those red and green snowflakes. Super, super pretty. Now all that's left to do is assemble the card. So I'm using two kinds of adhesives. They are my favorite. The iCraft Ultra Bond Liquid Adhesive, as well as the iCraft 3D Foam Squares. And I like to use the combo pack. That way I have both small and large squares, so I have the perfect size for whatever I'm trying to adhere down. I'm going to start with my snowflakes that are in the background and use the Ultra Bond Liquid Adhesive on those. And then I'll pop up just a couple of the snowflakes that are in the foreground. And I also stamped a sentiment from that Gina K. Designs Baby It's Cold Outside stamp set. And I popped that up with those iCraft 3D foam squares as well. So here is a look at that foil as well as that mixed Glitz glitter gel in the background. I hope you can really see all that glitter and shine. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Remember that all of the ThermoWeb products that I used are listed and linked in the video description below. I hope you like this holiday card, and thank you so much for watching. I will see you again soon. Bye! Thank you again very much for watching this video. If you liked this video and you'd like to see more from me, please hit that subscribe button that is on the screen now. And here are a few other videos that I thought you might enjoy.